Okay, so this is you right now. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Oh, Spider-Man No Way Home is gonna be awesome. I can't wait to see how Peter deals with the whole world now knowing his secret identity. I can't.
Okay, let me stop you right there, because how do I put this? You won't. Not really. First, a disclaimer. I never really liked that the MCU decided to do away with everyone's secret identities. It started with the first Iron Man, after which they just decided, nah, you know what? Let's treat these characters more like rock stars and less like humble heroes that hide from the public eye. Let's treat them like the celebrities that their actors are in real life. And I think that works for Iron Man. I don't think it needed to be the rule. Having said that, I like the idea of Peter Parker getting exposed simply because we haven't seen it before. And he's a kid. He is far more vulnerable to the public eye than these grown-ass men. However, it kinda ruins the dynamic between him and Jonah. Because traditionally, Jameson thinks that Spider-Man's a crook because he hates people who hide behind masks. And that's now off the table. And because he thinks that behind the mask of Spider-Man lies the face of a grown-ass man and a crook, a petty, self-centered, motherless criminal and con artist. And that's now off the table as well. And I have to say, if Jonah will still spend two-thirds of this movie hating on Peter and trying to make his life miserable, now knowing that Peter is just a teenager who lost his parents and lives with his aunt, and then that'll just make JJ seem like a retard. But something tells me you won't get to see much of that. In fact, I don't think you'll see the implications of this whole Peter gets exposed twist at all. Why? Well, stop me if any of this sounds familiar. Loki fake dies at the end of Thor 2, poses as Odin and takes the throne. What kind of damage is Loki gonna do? How is Thor gonna find him out? He finds him out immediately and defuses the situation. Rumlow takes critical damage and has a vendetta against Roger, setting up Crossbones for the next movie. How is Cap gonna deal with it? Rumlow dies immediately at the start of the next movie. Black Panther shows up out of nowhere and causes terrible damage. Who is this mysterious new assailant? What does he want? What's his allegiance? It's T'Challa. He just reveals himself immediately. Aunt May sees Peter take his mask off and curses off screen. We've been told how much she'd freak if she found Spidey out. How will this play out? How will she reconcile with the fact that her nephew is risking his life daily to actually, she's totally cool with it. Nothing is tension diffused. Zendaya stalks Peter Parker all throughout Homecoming, and Peter barely acknowledges her existence. How is she going to get his attention in the next one? How is she going to get on his radar? Oh no, he just likes her now. That's great. Half of the Earth dies at the end of Infinity War. How is the other half gonna deal with their loved ones no longer existing? How is the dead half gonna deal with them being brought back to life and having missed 5 years? They don't. They give it a throwaway line, but they really don't deal with it. One of Marvel's worst habits, in my opinion, is setting up things that they don't pay off. They just acknowledge that the problem exists, and then they move to reset the status quo immediately. And that makes most of the overarching narrative seem meaningless. I would say the two major exceptions to this are Bucky in Civil War and Ego in Guardians 2. Bucky escapes at the end of Captain America the Winter Soldier, and the movie makes it seem like finding him will be the focus of the next movie. And it is, at least for a while. The first act is Cap trying to find Bucky while Bucky is supposedly doing some nasty shit. The movie delivers on what its predecessor set up. Similarly, at the end of Guardians 1, we get teased about Star-Lord's father, who is supposed to be this big-shot alien power of unknown origin, and sure enough, Star-Lord's father is, in fact, the main focus and main antagonist of the next film. Oh, by the way, spoilers for for those of you who... Is that a little late? I mean, come on, you've seen these. But by the way, as a general rule, Marvel don't like to have too much connective tissue between their movies because they want their movies to be, for the most part, self-contained stories that don't have to acknowledge much of what came before. So Spider-Man No Way Home likely won't be what you think. It won't be Peter dealing with the world, knowing his secret. It won't be a battle of wits and morals between him and Jonah. It'll be Spidey fighting some random new villain, and that's it. Everything else will be in the background, and we're probably gonna see yet more things set up that they don't plan on paying off. I hope I'm wrong. If I am, I'll happily make a video about the new movie acknowledging that, although if it's anything like the last movie, yeah, count me out. Oh, by the way, these new Spider-Man movies, they have the same problem that the Batman Arkham games did, the problem of having to come up with the name before you come up with the movie. So I fully expect we'll see this reach ridiculous heights like Spider-Man No Way Home, No Way From Home, No Place Like Home, Homies in the Spider-Hood, Homewreckers, Homesteaders, Spider-Man Homesick, and of course, the inevitable crossover, Spider-Man Home Alone 4 featuring Macaulay Culkin as Gwen Stacy. And Joe Pesci as the biggest supervillain of the Spider-Man mythos, Avi Arad.
some more.